Yada yada hi dharmasya.
कर्तृभ्यो वंशर्षभ्यो महद्भ्यो नमो गुरुभ्यः सर्वोपप्लवरहित प्रज्ञान घन प्रत्यगर्थो ब्रह्माहमस्मि सोऽहमस्मि ब्रह्माहमस्मि ॐ प्रपन्न पारिजाताय तोत्र भेत्रैकपाणये ज्ञानमुद्राय कृष्णाय गीतामृतदुहे नमः My Paripurna Ashirvadams and best wishes, may Almighty Sri Venkateshwara bestow all kinds of prosperity, good health, wealth and eternal happiness to you and your entire family members and friends. Let us begin Srimad Bhagavad Gita, verse number 70 of second chapter. Shri Bhagavan Uvacha Apuryamanam Chala Pratishtham समुद्रमापः प्रविशन्ति यद्वत् तद्वत् कामायं प्रविशन्ति सर्वे स शान्तिमाप्नोति न कामकामी ब्यूटिफुल वर्ड्स कृष्ण डिफाइन्स द लक्षण ऑफ अ ज्ञानी बिकॉज ही इज अबाउट टू कंक्लूड इन टू मोर वर्सेस The Lakshana of Sthitaprajna. Sthitaprajna means who is a Jnani and as well as Yogi too. And given example is a ocean. And we have to add pond. Because, you know, I would like to tell an incident. Last week I had attended a function. So it was my devotee's house where the function was held. The function was Ayusha Homa. I think you might be aware about it because the birth anniversary, first birth anniversary of a baby. The baby was named, I suggested because they had requested me and it was born as a Krishna's nakshatra. Therefore, I named it as a Rohini. Okay. So, when I went there, so it was grand arrangement. I was a little bit stunned, you know. Because nowhere I have seen celebrating this first year at birth anniversary in this grand way. That function had three segments, you know. The first, they had Abhishega. Abhishega means the morning 5:30 Abhishega in the temples. So because there is a huge temple. So we had all of us, we had gone there. We had a nice darshan of Abhishega and Alankara with the Shodasopachara Puja. And the 8:30 a.m. there was a Namakarana function, the naming ceremony. Usually, 1 year few people they don't name it. Even this Jataka Kundali, you know, Jataka we should not write for 1 year. After that we can. Maybe, you know, that 1 year we need not to have any predictions or pre-judgment on that baby. Therefore, we usually don't do that. And after that, the name was selected that was about to keep present in front of her. Everything was good. So grand ceremony, that homa, that fire ritual had begun by 8:30. I could see the yajamana. So yajamana means who is that? The father of that baby has to be an yajamana. So yajamana means he is the author of a homa. So when he was sitting a little bit with restless mind, I thought something wrong, I called him. Because that's very important. When you sit as an yajamana, you have to be calm and quiet and you have to be completely relaxed. When they ask, they provide akshata. Akshata means that which never go into destruction. So that's the symbolically Puranatva. To attain the Puranatva, completeness, the Akshata is provided you to use for the Sankalpa. With Akshata, certain flowers, and everything was given, but mentally I was not ready. Then I thought, okay, this is not good. I invited him, I called him and asked, is there anything problem? He said, no, no, Swamiji, no. I said, it's very serious. When you are sitting in front of fire ritual, you have to be very careful. Tell me whatever that you have. Then he said, no, Swamiji, actually it's not the big thing, but I had ordered a necklace for my baby. So I thought they would have supplied yesterday itself, but nobody received here. When I called today morning, you know, half an hour before, he said that today evening alone it will be available. But Swamiji, I wanted to present to my daughter. It was my ambition. Ambition means, I'm using that word ambition. So that's my, you know, my part as a father I have to give. That's what I feel. Then I said, okay, this is not a big deal. It will come, don't worry. But when you sit for Sankalpa, you be proper. Otherwise, go and relax yourself and come back. I talked to the Brahmins, and the Brahmanas, they understood, okay, Swamiji is doing something. And he took 20 minutes. Then he came. He came with okay, okay mind, but I have asked, forget everything. Because when you sit in front of the karma, you have to be completely dedicated to that karma, whether you believe there is a God or not, doesn't matter. You just, when you sit for the karma, you have to dedicate yourself. Therefore, I said, forget everything. You sit and listen to the words which Brahmana says, repeat it, don't think anything else. Then he got done that. Then after that, I thought, okay, that guy had become normal. No, he was not. Then I could hear the voice bursting, shouting to his workers and just thrashing his driver and fighting with his wife. Oh, this man had become mad. Then I called his manager and said, have you sent somebody to reach Swamiji? It will come in 20 minutes. So, but he is not listening. And I asked him to come and sit nearby me, because when he sits nearby me, so artificially, at least he should be okay. Therefore, he was sitting nearby me, and he was about to move, then I stopped him. Don't go here and there. And Nicholas had come exactly before the naming ceremony. So he became very excited again, the same body language, bursting, jumping, and talking to the people, shouting, but with different emotions. I started observing. And also I was observing the baby, who was completely detached with the circumstances, conditions, so relaxed, with a happy-minded bala eva jnani nam manaha. So the jnani's mind is like a child baby. She was not worried at all. So he made a sankalpa to present a pendant or necklace, whatever it is, but because of his own sankalpa, he made himself pressurized, but baby was detached. She was not at all worried, bothered. Because when you look at the baby, you are attracted. Many people say that because that the bird-like skin, it is attracted. No, the mind which is endowed with completely joy, it is attracted. That's what, you know, when a baby's mind is filled with overjoy, what can't be? So what happens in between? As we grow, all likes and dislikes, raga, dvesha, it comes, occupies, and our perception, everything changes. But a jnani, so who is like a baby? And there was one more incident which took place thousands of years ago, when Rama, Lord Rama, when he was in a young age, he was announced for his coronation. Rama's Pattabhishekam was announced. All Ayodhya became so excited. Everybody started celebrating except Rama. So Rama kept very silent. Now you see, so when you are happy, so you express it. So that expression, it shows that expression, it can be organized, not the happiness. Okay, so that expression, it shows that whether you are victimized by the emotion. So Rama kept quiet. And that same scenario, it completely changed after few days, and he was sent to forest. In the forest, no hut was there. They Parnashala, the hut was they created, and they slept in the bare land, not having cushion bed like it was in the palace. The yesterday, the day they went, the previous day they slept in the bed in the palace. But on this day, Lakshmana was observing when Rama lie down, immediately he slept. And he didn't feel anything bad about it. No expression, not even inside the joyful face, it remained it. You cannot make artificial face when you face this kind of problems. So unknowingly your eyes will set tears. It will compare, your own mind will compare past and future and present. So when you are driven, kicked off from a kingdom, you will be endowed with the fear of the future. It was not there with Rama. And you will be pity on yourself. It was not with Rama. And you will be thinking about the past which went wrong. He should have done this. I should have not done this. So all people's expectations and omissions and commissions, Rama was not endowed with anything. He was very peaceful minded. How it is possible? That is possible only when you realize about yourself. That's what explained here, version. So the given example is version. Two adjectives are given here. Apuryamanam achala pratittham. Apuryamanam means a brimful ocean. So ocean is full of water. It doesn't require any more water because that it is already filled with contentment. So when the ocean is already endowed with water, it doesn't expect, it doesn't long for any water like the lake or pond. So when there is a pond, so lacking of the water, it has to depend on the rain or other sources like a small, small river, a small, small bore well. But ocean remains the ocean. Okay, chalo. But when so many rivers, they merge with the ocean, so ocean never change his measurement. It never increase its blim. It remains as the ocean. As ocean, because when so many rivers are merging, the quantity doesn't increase. That's what, you know, it doesn't have the longing. It doesn't overflow. The pond and lake has got both. So there is no water and depend on the rain or other sources. When it becomes too much water, the barriers, that borders, it is broken. So when lake is broken, that's all. It distracts all other people too. Like the two minds, normal people's mind is like the lake or pond which expects, which depended on the emotional aspects and worldly object, and which is fluctuated and victimized by the desires. Once you have the desire of something, you cannot sleep. That's what, you know, we have to be very careful with our own mind. Do you believe that? Because our mind, which doesn't have the desire, is craved for by Jnani. It's purposely, you need not do it. You cannot do it. So if I ask you, you know, just clear all the thoughts from your mind, it is not possible. So you go to the caves, go to Himalayas. I used to go to Himalayas deep into the forest for a long time, and I used to have the meditation. I didn't feel any difference between a crowded place and the caves where no human smell even cannot be found. No, both are same. Wherever you go, you are endowed with your thoughts, your preconclusions, prejudice. You have to face yourself, because you have your own world completely with you. That's what mind. So mind is endowed with thoughts. Those thoughts are nothing but the experience which had happened, which had taken place in the past with you when you connected with the world. That's what, you know, usually I say, when you have a gulab jamun first time, you just experience the gulab jamun, the connection. When you put in your mouth, that connection of your tongue and that sugar and that all the ingredients, it gives an experience, okay? But when you have the second gulab jamun, you don't take second gulab jamun. So you are remaining or remembering the experience of the first gulab jamun, the conjunction. Therefore, mind, you can remove all the object. Therefore, many people I have seen, you know, they create a meditation hall, no furniture, no object. They go and sit, but they are not able to connect with the meditation. Because the all the object which is in the form of experiences, it bugs you. For example, when I ask, you know, don't think anything. Just sit for a long time. Last class also I said that. Just don't think anything. When you say don't think anything, then you will say that how can I don't myself thinking something else? So you will start thinking that mind will work in different way. Therefore, a jnani's mind, which is like a ocean. Ocean means so many thoughts may come or go, but yourself, you are endowed with yourself, with joyful, with bliss. That's what the proper word. Therefore, it is known as apuryamanam. You need not to get anything from outside, because you are endowed with adequacy, purnatvam. When you feel yourself, when you feel means when you accept yourself, you realize yourself as a complete person, you need not to expect from outside. At the same time, so you are not overwhelmed, overflowed by your joyfulness. It remains as the ocean. That person, you know, this mind of a jnani cannot be victimized or fluctuate or deviated by any desire. So even thousands of desire may take place, he won't be victimized with that. But not kamakami. Kamakami means who is always victimized by the desires like a pond and lakes. So Rama was like that, even baby. So baby's mind is completely filled with joy. When you go to in front of the baby, you can feel the sannidhyam of the joyful mind. Okay? Okay, the next words, let us read it. Vihaya kamanya sarvan pumamscharati nispruhaha nirmamo nirahankaraha sashantimadhigacchati. So finally, he gives great techniques of Ajnani. Who doesn't have Mamakara and Ahankara? The two things. It's impossible. If you want to do something, you need to have Ahankara. And if you want to take your life furthermore, you need to have Mamakara. It is impossible to live without Ahankara and Mamakara. We have a little bit, we have seen what Ahankara is in early, in previous sessions. Now you see that when you own your body, automatically you have the feeling this body is mine. Nobody need to teach it. Just you have, if I ask you, you know, so what about your sharira, who's it? That's mine. It's mine. So that mind, he says, you know, nirmamaha. Not only with body. If you had taken a new car, if somebody, you know, makes a line, scratcher, that's all. You cannot sleep for a day. Because when there is a scratcher for more than 2 feet, you have to change that side itself. That's what car company. We usually say that after receiving a car, after buying a car, so kaam khatam ho gaya. So we have got a car. No. So you have become under control of the car company. So he will be counting your kilometers. Every kilometer has counted there. After 5,000 kilometers, you have to get it done the service. After the 10,000 kilometers, you have to change your diesel filter, oil filter, everything. So many things are there. After 15,000, once in the 15,000, you have to change all the tires. And finally, you will realize, my God, I thought after buying the car, everything was completed, finished. But it has begun like that. So when the life begins, your mamakara has spurs. My body, my things, my people, my son. So this mine, it enlarges. But he says, the person who is not endowed with mamakara, how it is possible? And that too, nirahankara. Ahankara rahitaha. So these two aspects, and nispruhaha, who doesn't have attachment at all, not even single bit of attachment. Yaha, one who sarvan kaman vihaya, dropping all the desires, nispruhaha charati, one who lives with the detachment, that person who is also endowed with the nirmamaha, nirahankaraha, sa shantim adhigacchati, he alone can attain the moksha. Here shanti means moksha. How it is possible? It seems to be impossible. But Krishna has got his own style of making us understand, so that we will continue from tomorrow. See you tomorrow in the next episode. Harihi Om. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Harihi Om. Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om.